in the future from occurring. Most commonly, the claim scrubber errors that we see are things, errors generated by the front desk staff that I talked about relationship to subscriber, subscriber ID, those type things. Those are preventable errors through education and follow-up with the staff. Again, reporting back to them the number of errors that are occurring, what type of errors they are, and monitoring and reporting those will reduce those significantly. Processing of the accounts receivable aging report. Two forms of aging reports that we categorize things in. One, patient or guarantor liability, monitoring the aging of these accounts receivable, what the patient owes, processing these and turning them over to a collection agency timely. Typically, we recommend sending two monthly statements to the guarantor, sending a 15-day letter at the 75th day, which is basically telling them we've submitted multiple statements to you, we've not heard from you, we've not received payment. Your account may be considered for further collection process. If they don't respond to that letter, we recommend placing those balances if a payment plan hasn't been established with the collection agency. Same thing with processing of insurance aging, looking at the insurance aging by insurance company, monitoring any of those claims getting over 45 to 60 days, and following up with the insurance companies, not by simply just resubmitting the claim, calling and verifying that they have received the claim, making sure that an EOB hasn't been lost in processing, and then submit the claim if necessary or any additional documentation. Tracking errors, we've beat that one to death today. Track your errors, report on the errors to the staff, how to prevent them, educate, educate, educate. Last bullet on this slide, incentivize your staff. We talked about this a little bit. Filling up your schedule, accuracy in posting, accuracy.